गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर टुडेज क्लास। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द अनदर सब टॉपिक ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1। द टाइटल ऑफ द सब टॉपिक इज टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दैट इज पब्लिक फैसिलिटीज एंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी डेवलपमेंट। दीज आर द टू लास्ट सब टॉपिक्स ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1, दैट इज डेवलपमेंट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज मेंट बाय पब्लिक फैसिलिटीज। I hope you will be knowing that what is meant by public facility basically. But as far as our subject is concerned, what is meant by this public facilities, the basic facilities which are provided to us by the government. Many people believe that the government should open schools so that our children have a chance to study. Obviously, it is right. And some other examples of public facilities are healthcare centers, better roads, ensured unadulterated medicines, safety, recreation, place of worships, etc. These are some other examples of public facilities. Now, another way, the public facilities are needed to be provided to citizens. Again, for example, hospitals and sanitation, electricity, communication system, public transport, schools and colleges, fire brigade, roads, trains, airports, etc. These are known as the public facilities. Shortly, we say the public facilities are healthcare, sanitation, electricity, public transport, schools and colleges, etc. Again, we say these are known as the public facilities. Now, according to a textbook which is mentioned there, public facilities which are provided by the government are considered publicly, like as four pictures are there. All of you will go through with these four pictures, is it? And we have discussed all these pictures. We see, as we know that Punjab has more income than average person in Kerala. But Kerala has low infant mortality rate because it is better system like PDS which provide health and nutritional states to the children or state. That means, which we have discussed already in our previous lecture, that Punjab has the highest income as Kerala has low, but the infant low, but the infant mortality rate IMR of Punjab is high as compared to Kerala. Means in one parameter Kerala is ahead and in second parameter Kerala is overhead on Punjab. That means the low mortality rate in Kerala is only because of betterment in PDS system or healthcare system. We need public facilities because we are not able to purchase all things by money. That means public facilities are playing very important role for the development of individual or for the development of a country, because we can't say money is not able to buy all the things which we have required. Money in your pocket can't buy all the goods and services that you may need to live well. All of you will be knowing that thing. One more thing, your money can't buy the pollution-free environment or ensure that you will get unadulterated medicines unless you can afford to shift to a community that already has all these things. These are the things which we can't buy with money. Again, money may also not be able to protect you from infectious diseases unless the whole of our community takes preventive steps. This point you can apply presently, according to present scenario, COVID-19 is prevailing in whole country, we say, or whole world presently. That means the richest persons, or we say the nominated business tycoons, they are also failed to protect unless they have to take preventive measures for protecting ourselves and others as well. Now the another point is sustainable development. First of all, sustainable development is that kind of development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. Geo Hermelin Bertrand Land first introduced the concept of sustainable development in 1986. He was then the Prime Minister of Norway and Chairman of the World Commission on Environment and Development. Introduction regarding sustainable development. The term sustainable development first came to prominence in the World Conservation Strategy, that is WCS, in 1980. It achieved new states with the publication of two significant reports by Bertrand on South, North and South, a program for survival and common crisis in 1985. Third, our common future in 1983 and has gained ever greater attention since the United Nations Conference on Environment and Development, UNCED, held in Rio de Janeiro in June 1992. Sustainable development. What is the main aim of sustainable development? Firstly, improvement of lifestyle and well-being and preserving natural resources and ecosystem. The evaluation of SD concept, already we have discussed, Rio de Johannesburg, is it? It is the landmark event in the evolution of the concept of sustainable development that had been in 1972, Stockholm Conference on the Human Environment convened by the United Nations, the report of the World Commission on Environment and Development. Next one, our common future, already we have discussed this, UNCED. Next one, which we have not discussed, that is UN establishing the Commission on Sustainable Development, that is CSD, in December 1992, to ensure an effective follow-up of UNICEF and to monitor the report on the implementation of Earth Summit agreements at the local, national, regional and international levels. Again, the Rio Plus 5 special session on the General Assembly held on June 1997 adopted a comprehensive program for further implementation of Agenda 21 as well as the work program of the CSD for 1997 to 2002. The last, that is the Kyoto Protocol, adopted in December 1997, and the Conference of the Parties, that is COPs, held over the years, had made some advances relating to clarification of various aspects of financing and implementing sustainable development globally. The two main aims of sustainable development are as maximizing the probability of achieving sustainable development. Secondly, to minimize the chances of environmental degradation. Four major components of sustainable development are the climatic change, nutrient cycles, hydrological cycle and biodiversity. Sustainability of development. Now I come to your textbook. Since the second half of the 20th century, a number of scientists have been warned that the present type and the levels of development are not sustainable. Resources are replenished by nature, as in the case of crops and plants. In the case of groundwater, if we use more than what is being replenished by rain, then we should be overusing this resource. The consequence of environmental degradation. Don't respect national or state boundaries. This issue is no longer region or nation specific. Our future is linked together. And sustainability of development, comparatively a new area of knowledge in which scientists, economists, philosophers or other social scientists are working together. The question of development or progress is perennial. So the debate on development continues. Okay, thank you.